Okay, it is day one of the Bachelorette trip. We drove up from Eau Claire, and I'm very excited, a little bit nervous for mostly the bears, if there are any, but I am most excited for the quality time that I get to spend with Ben, uninterrupted, because there is no cell service, and we'll be out there for 4 days.
All right, day one, we traveled from Eau Claire to the Hungry Jack Outfitters, where we are right now in bunk room 3. We had a pretty good day. Allison got a little hangry, so we picked up some donuts, some Jimmy John's subs, made it to Hungry Jack Outfitters, where we will be waking up tomorrow morning to start our first day out in the Boundary Waters at 7 a.m. for breakfast. Actually, 6 a.m. for a nice shower, our first shower before we head out for 4 days. And the outfitter guide, Dave, will be explaining our route to us so we don't get lost, hopefully. I did lose the first game of cribbage, so rough start for me, but I know I will do better on day two.
While my body slept in my bed, my mind was running through the woods instead.
100 okay, miles an hour off our in car the fast lane. And our canoe.
100 miles an hour in my head.
Now we're off to start our official adventure.
And vagabond dreaming takes me. Sipping whiskey by the river, living out of sight. 100 miles an hour in the fast lane.
Portage 2.
This is awesome.
100 miles an
this
hour.
This is the hard. Line. This is way harder than I thought.
We are weak. That's what
we're weak.
See the curve.
It's just hard to get in the heavy, huge bags out of the canoe when you're slipping on rocks. These bags weigh whatever.
100 miles an hour in the fast lane. 100 miles an hour to the end.
Yeah.
Yep.
Let's go! We were told that the first part would be the most bug-filled and has lived up to the hype. Let's see that strength. Oh, yeah. Good flip.
My heart just
now we're off.
Like
let's
Cherokee
go.
Drop.
Proud of myself because that was fun.
100 miles an hour in the fast lane. 100 miles an hour in the fast lane. 100 miles an hour to the moon.
Battle of the day, or shortest portage of the day.
So, 24 rods.
When you stop the bugs, aka swarm. Mosquitoes swarm.
Now, old man river, what you doing now? Oh, you know it ain't gonna help. Old man river got his hands in the mud. He's looking
Let's
for
go.
Gold in the wishing well.
Get out of here. One, time for lunch break. What do we got on the menu today?
Jimmy John's sandwiches bought yesterday and not refrigerated. So, will we be pooping our brains out? We don't know.
Now I drink coffee while she's hanging.
Campsite, whatever, on Snipe Lake. We got a little fire grate, bench, and look at that. A little island out there. canoe. Beautiful day. Not too hot, not too cold.
It's 1:30. That's great.
1:30. Good time. Boundary waters fish, a small northern. She's going to attempt to take it off.
I can't.
You got this. You're wearing gloves. Okay, first grab the line. Good. Okay. Now when you pull the fish, keep it up over the boat.
It's all tangled.
It's okay. Grab the fish with one hand. Grab it tight like you mean it. Yes. Okay. Now with the other hand, you're going to grab the hook and try and rip it out of its mouth. By pulling up and out.
Oh!
You did it!
I'm not kissing.
Give it a kiss. So we went through 3 or 4 lakes. Mosquitoes were really bad in the portages, but we found a really good campsite that doesn't have any bugs.
Yes, mosquitoes are definitely the worst part.
It's day, our first day really out here, and I already have stains all over my one pair of pants that I want to wear. But life will go on.
Pretty boy in the woods.
That's me. Gotta look fab. Yeah, tomorrow, big day.
The longest portage of our trip. The 2 longest portages of our trip in the same day. Rain so hard that a tent started
leaking on us. Alright, Sunday morning, day 3. Putting away the tent in the morning. It's probably, 6:30 a.m.?
Yeah.
Bugs are crazy this morning, hence the full gear.
In the canoe. Just saying we could. Half my time. Take all of the potion. Take hold of my hand. Ignore all the omens. Cause we know we can. In
the swamp. Mosquitoes are just everywhere. A little tiny speaker. Rain so hard that our tent started leaking on us. We've got 255 rods with a little lake crossing that we have to walk through, I guess. And it starts uphill. It's supposed to be the second hardest portage in all of the boundary waters, so.
But it's our last portage of the day, so that's good.
One of the day, so.
And we are strong.
Here we go. Yeah, Allison, you're crushing! Woo! Back up and take the water. Please. Please. Halfway.
Over half.
That was so hard. My shoulders hurt. Where's the water? That was the worst thing of my life. I made it to Tuscarora. Woo! The hardest portage we had, and we get there, and there's a thunderstorm. Yeah! Let's go! Just what I needed. Oh, that portage was so hard. I was screaming just to get through it. It is raining and thundering, so we've got the hammock bug net set up to rest for a little. Swim or a bath.
And a Pop-Tart.
And a Pop-Tart. Now for the bug spray. Really nice scene. And I'm in love. And I don't know what to say. Thank you, Lord, for that sundress on that Saturday. Walking barefoot down the beach. Smell of the rain up in the air. Smell of flowers in the air. And I swear on my life, if you need a joke, I'll be there. You need a smoke, you take my spare. I always thought you were far. So what do you say?
Eating ramen out in the boat because the bugs are so bad at the camps.
We had our two longest portages today, a 255 rod and a 100 rod, back to back.
Go super hard on the last one, I almost made it.
Yeah, so proud.
Very hard. I was just like yelling.
Ben is literally screaming in the woods.
Get me to the water. And then we get to Tuscarora.
Lake.
Yeah. Lake. And it's like
thunderstorm.
It's a thunderstorm. So we're
trying to paddle as fast as we can to find a campsite. And the first one, take it. Second one, take it. We're just so upset.
Then we finally found a third one, set up the hammock, and the rain fly and just took a nap.
Took a nap. We were pooped. Gonna play cribbage, read our books, go to bed. Good morning from day three.
Day four?
Four.
Five.
We look rough and we smell bad. But there's a pretty sunset outside. Sunrise.
Never knew how to tell a lie. Head out. Being honest, man, till I
die, you know. It's young love. Good morning from day three. It's super sunny out on the lake. We are getting ready to go out on our adventure. We have three portages today. Hopefully lots of fishing, but it's supposed to get up to 95.
I believe in you, baby. we go.
Who's a beast?
Me.
Look at how sweaty you are.
Ooh. I just carried this for 100 rods. Without stopping.
Good ride.
I was on the move, but it was dead.
We're live, coming to you from Gillis
Lake. This is our last campsite for our trip, but here you have a nice little rock that goes out and then just drops off. We're gonna do some great swimming. You put our canoe up, and then you travel up this big hill, which is okay. You have a great open area, some trees, which we are gonna hang our hammock from. Get a nice view. This is our view from our kitchen living room.
Wow.
And then our bedroom. Our tent is gonna go right over there. All overlooking this massive cliff with a great view of the lake.
And the wind is coming in, so there's not many bugs here. Huge.
This is a huge win for us today.
This is a big win today.
Yeah! Woo!
Dogs. Oh. It's like I know one thing that's totally got into the water. We're gonna go for a little float swim.
Huge storm.
Like 60 mile an hour wind gusts. Thank God we had the canoe tied down. We could hear it just flapping in the wind like a flag, no joke. And
everywhere. We have literally everything we own in our bag. Fishing poles, canoe paddles.
I sprinted outside and grabbed everything and threw it in the tent before it could blow away.
I don't know if you can hear the storm or the rain, but
this is insane.
Yikes!
It's been half an hour and we're down to a little bit of a sprinkle and still some thunder.
The real MVP of this trip.
That was our tent is a holding and she's dripping a little, but
she's leaking. But it's okay. We have orders for our tent. Day 5. We lived through the storm. It was touch and go last night for a little bit. And we ended up sleeping with our paddles. And our fishing poles. And our bags and my shoes and everything in our tent.
Well, after the storm, the food bag is unmoved. Let's go. Alright, canoe update after the storm. The canoe was tied onto that tree, but it was laying here, face down with the bottom up. And then it flipped over and flew all the way from here, still tied to that tree, over to this spot. And then I came out in the storm and tied this hammock strap on around those trees for double protection.
I am floating in deep water, like the unfamiliar otter, in love with someone's daughter. I'm going to lose float, and I know that I love her for the stars and all they cover. Will it end?